body arrived this morning in Chato, his home village, where he's going to be buried tomorrow. Well, today, close family and friends were able to pay their last respects. Now, Magufuli died at the age of 61 from heart complications.
Bye, bye, bye. Chato, Geita and neighboring residents today paid their last respects to the late president at the Magufuli Stadium. As has been the norm all week, as his body was moving through different towns of Tanzania to allow for public mourning. Security has been heightened as the ceremony was led by Prime Minister Kassim Majaliwa and attended by the second Vice President of Zanzibar, Hemed Suleiman Abdallah, and Head of Defense Forces, General Venance Mabeyo. Magufuli's body lay in state as members of public bid him farewell. Unlike other days of the week, where it made a procession through major Tanzanian towns, thousands lined up as the hearse containing the coffin made way into grounds on Thursday, accompanied by major military vehicles. Despite fears of widespread infections of COVID-19, major mourners still wore no masks. Zanzibar's second VP, Suleiman Abdallah, praised the president for taking lead on several development projects in the East African nation, saying that he left a legacy in all sectors, including education, finance, transport, among others. Tanzania is in mourning, but for Chato, it is more than that. For this is the last time they will ever get to see their beloved son, former President John Pombe Magufuli.